Holy Mass. Today is Friday, October 1st, the obligatory memorial of St. Teresa of the Child of Jesus, Virgin and Doctor of the Church, also known as the Little Flower. Our Mass is being offered for the intentions of Ben and Jack Ford. Please rise and greet our celebrant, Father Valapie, and join us in singing the Ten Found on page 563, 560.
Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God. And everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, and that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not burdensome. For whoever is begotten by God conquers the world, and the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world, but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Glory to you, O Lord.
The disciples approached Jesus and said, Who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? He called a child over, placed it in their midst, and said, Amen. I say to you, unless you turn and become like children, you will not enter the kingdom of heaven. But whoever humbles himself like this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoever receives one child such as this in my name receives me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So boys and girls, I guess all of us are adults are looking to you and saying, wow, whoever becomes a child really enters the kingdom of heaven. So how about all of us big guys and big ladies? Do we have to come back to becoming little children? Well, in one sense, yes. You know, as we grow and mature, as we get older, at your age, you want to grow up. At our age, we want to go back down. It's important to understand. You know, there's a certain sense of growth and maturity, right? Going into the next grade, getting older, being independent, going places. That's all well and good. That happens to us physically, right? You can see us getting taller, getting a little older, mature. That happens to us in our bodies. But what about our soul? Does our soul age with our bodies? Well, one of the secrets of life is to allow that not to happen. To allow our souls to be very young and innocent. Our soul is our spiritual body. Just like we have a physical body, right? Within our bodies is a spiritual body called a soul. And we want to keep that young, innocent, and pure. So no matter how old we are, whether we're 7 or 77, we want to keep our souls at a young, tender age. Jesus says, you want to enter the kingdom of heaven? Okay, I want to show you. You need to look at the soul of young people who trust their father for everything. When we were children, boys and girls, when, of course, right now, we have a trust for those who will care for us. You know, we have a house and a bed to sleep in. We have food in our refrigerators. We're sent to a beautiful blue ribbon school. We're being educated and formed in the faith of Jesus Christ. Wow, what could be better? We have people who love us and care for us. And so we trust that everything will be taken care of. There's a trust that goes on by being innocent and young like a child. And see, this is what Jesus is speaking about that. Because when I think we get older, somehow we lose that complete dependence and trust. You know why? Because we want to do it. We want to take care of everything. But God still wants to be Father. God still wants to care for us. He doesn't want us to ever forget that. And that we need to depend on Him. To include Him in all of our decisions and our conversations. Well, sometimes that's not as easy as it sounds. But we have to remember that. When the disciples asked Jesus that very important question, it was a very important question. Who is the greatest in heaven? People may think, well, those who are most holy, those who really know the faith, those who understand all of this. That wasn't Jesus' answer. He says, okay, I'm going to show you. Brings a little child over. He says, okay, you want to know who's the greatest in heaven? A child who completely depends on God, who does not depend on him or herself. That's why I said at the beginning of the homily, even though we grow up physically, we have to make sure that spiritually we remain as children dependent on God. Now, you adults, you understand that, right? That's important to do because it helps your relationship with Jesus Christ. Once our ego is inflated and we think we could handle everything because there's a certain independence about that, we grow lack in that kind of true dependency on God. And our faith relationship diminishes. The more and more our ego is inflated, our soul is deflated. Does that make sense? So we have to make sure that we completely rely on God. I say that's easier said than done, because I have to ask all of you, are you going to Mass every Sunday? Oh, you're all here now, it's Friday. Will all of you be back on Sunday? Don't answer that out loud, this is not confession. But you have to answer yourself that question. Yes or no? You already know the answer. Now, you don't drive. I don't think you do. But you need someone to take you. And that's a very serious responsibility of those who take care of you. As God takes care of us, he places mommies and daddies that care for us. Not only physically, but spiritually. Mommy and daddy takes care of your body, your mind. And mommy and daddy are to take care of your soul. And if this is all important today, it should be important every Sunday. Absolutely. Are we here because the school made us come here? And that it doesn't make us come on Sunday? So those are serious questions that we all ask as we rely on God and we depend on him. He's not going to remind us to pray, right? So when we get up in the morning, make sure we pray, right? Isn't it beautiful that we go to a Catholic school and our teachers begin our day with prayer? It's very nice. But we have to make sure we keep those practices. Mom and Dad teaches us our prayers. It's so beautiful. Mom and Dad teaches us feast days and celebrations about our faith. That's so beautiful. Today, on October the 1st, we celebrate a feast day. And you see her statue in front of this altar. Her name is Saint Thérèse of the Little Flower. Saint Thérèse of Lisieux. Lisieux is a place in France. Her name is Saint Thérèse of the Little Flower. Sometimes people call her the Little Flower. Sometimes you'll hear Saint Thérèse. Sometimes you hear Saint Teresa. Sometimes you hear Saint Thérèse of Lisieux. But there she is. She was a sister. Another word for sister may be nun. N-U-N, right? A nun. I know some of you guys have never seen a nun, but that's what they look like. Some of us older folks know what nuns are, and we have seen sisters. And she was a sister, a nun. And she gave herself completely to God. And she based everything about her life concerning love, because she wanted to love God totally, totally. And not only to love God totally, but she wanted to live a simple life, totally dependent on God, just like this gospel talks about. Unless you become like a child, you can't enter the kingdom of heaven. So she relied totally on God. She depended on him for everything. Now, don't get me wrong. We have to do our part. We just can't say to God, you take care of everything. I'm not doing anything. That's not the way that we are to have a relationship with God. God doesn't want us not to be part of the plan. He wants us to be part of the plan. But he wants us to have a beautiful relationship with God, with himself. But he wants us to also work with that relationship by what we say and what we do. How we treat each other. Are we nice to everybody that we meet? Are we kind and considerate? Do we play fairly and include other people in our games? That's important to know. Not only for a day, but all the time. You might see some roses next to her. You might see some roses around these candles, around the altar. Well, that's really purpose, a purpose for that. Because Saint Thérèse said, and it's so beautiful, she's just a beautiful person. She says, I'm going to spend my heaven doing good things for people. Thank you, Thérèse. That's nice. And the way that you'll know that I heard you is I'll send you a rose. Could you imagine that? Isn't that nice? I'm going to send you a rose, she said, from heaven. And you'll find it when you ask me to pray with you. That's important. I think Catholics think that we just tell saints to pray for us. Now, I think Catholics, which means me too, we have to really understand that we're asking the saints to pray with us, not for us. That's very important. There's a relationship that has to go on. So we say, Thérèse, would you pray with us? And whisper our prayers as well. We're going to whisper our prayers to the ears of Jesus, absolutely. But we want you to whisper the prayer with us. Because the more people that whisper the prayer to Jesus, the better. So, Thérèse, we're not asking you to pray for us. We're asking you to pray with us, as we ask all the saints. And absolutely, she does. So when I was newly ordained, back in the day, 30 years ago, I was praying a novena, that's a prayer for 9 days, to Saint Thérèse. And I was finished it. I was finished the novena. I had to go back to my deacon parish St. Martin of Tours on Roosevelt Boulevard in Northeast Philadelphia, where I was assigned right before my ordination. And I was back here as a newly ordained priest to celebrate Mass for the people. Just like Deacon Jonathan is coming back for 40 hours. So I went back and I went to the back door of the rectory, and the housekeeper answered the door. Her name was Anna O'Flaherty from Ireland. Well, she said, "Hello, Father. Welcome back." I said, "Anna, it's so nice to see you." "'Tis a pleasure for us, Father. Very nice to see you. Look at you now, a newly ordained priest." I said, "Isn't this amazing, Anna? How beautiful it is for me to be back here at St. Martin's." She goes, "Father, come in, please." She says, "I'm going to have to give you something. Someone stopped by the rectory and gave this for you." I said, "Really?" I said, "Oh, that's very nice." And then she proceeded to take me into the kitchen. I thought, "Well, this is even better." And she opened the refrigerator. I thought, "Oh my gosh, I'm winning the prize." So she opened the refrigerator and came out a little plastic container with a rose. She said, "Oh, Father, here." I said, "Anna, who gave you this?" "I don't know." She did not give her name. I said, "Really?" I said, "Anna, I just finished the novena of St. Thérèse today." "Well, there you are, Father. She showered you with a rose. Your prayer is answered." I just stood there. You could have knocked me over with a feather. I said, "Anna, thank you very much. It was a rose for your lapel, for your jacket." Well, immediately I put it on, and I thanked her. I'm even getting a little, like, goosebumps now telling you the story 30 years ago. It's just a beautiful, again, that we're connected to our friends in heaven. I think we all know that. But she's our friend. And today we celebrate her feast day, October the 1st, St. Thérèse. She's usually right there. We put the statue right there above these candles. And how nice that is to be reminded. She is one of, I guess, you could say she's in the Hall of Fame among the saints, right? I mean, there's a lot of saints, a lot of them. But I have to say she's probably in the Hall of Fame along with Padre Pio. That's why they get prominence in our church. Well, today, may we understand what she understood about the little way, the littleness. As long as you grow up, boys and girls, just keep your soul young. That's what we learn as adults. We grow up, we get older, but we want our soul to be young. Our body could age, but our soul, no. Because we want to depend completely on God, like she did. St. Thérèse, pray for us. After reflecting on God's loving word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For Pope Francis and all the clergy, may God grant them strength and courage in teaching the word of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a greater respect for life throughout the world, from conception through natural death, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For people struggling with addictions, may God's grace and courage fill their hearts and give them strength. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may Jesus strengthen us as we seek to build God's kingdom here on earth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
have died marked with the sign of faith may they soon be welcomed into the heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, especially Nydia and Aiden Malone, Doris Marsh, Mike Marshall, and all of those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intentions of Ben and Jack Ford, for which this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they are in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Our offertory hymn is Immaculate Mary, number 201 in Breaking Bread, number 201 in Breaking Bread.
Oh,
like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Church,
and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
This is a reminder, boys and girls, when you come up to receive our Lord and Holy Communion, make sure you lower the mask from the bridge of your nose to the chin. Just leave the mask on your face, but just lower it. And then when you receive, step aside, place the host in your mouth, and then you can walk back to it.
Body of Christ. body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Body of Christ.
with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Have a nice weekend, everybody.
Peace to God.
St. Michael,
the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Our recession hymn is "Though Know We Are Christians," number 583 in the Breaking Bread, number 583 in the Breaking Bread.